My name is Oktar Babun. I'm a medical doctor, brain surgeon from Turkey. I'm going to speak on behalf of Harun Yahya. Harun Yahya is a Muslim intellectual, internationally known Muslim intellectual, who has written more than 250 books, science, faith, and politics related. And this talk is going to be based upon the works of Harun Yahya. The theory of evolution, which claims that all living beings are products of coincidences and denies the existence of a creator, is the most powerful ideology against religion today. The theory of evolution, which seems to be a scientific issue, has become the so-called scientific foundation of the many isms of the 20th century, such as communism, fascism, terrorism, anarchism, racism, are all founded upon the concepts of Darwinism and the theory of evolution. Now we will talk about the bloody alliance of fascism and Darwinism. What is fascism? Fascism is the fruit of the law or the jungle. The concept of Darwinism, struggle for survival, survival of the fittest, and the strong one survives and the weak ones get eliminated. And there's a constant conflict in the nature. These concepts were taken from Darwinism and were applied into fascism and Nazism by the prominent leaders of the fascism, such as Adolf Hitler or Alfred Rosenberg. And they got the struggle concepts of Darwinism and applied there's a struggle between different races. Now, I want to start with Charles Darwin. Charles Darwin, he himself was a racist, and he used his theory as a scientific justification for racism. In his book, The Descent of Man, he said, "At some future period, not very distant as measured by centuries, the civilized races of man will almost certainly exterminate and replace the savage races throughout the world. At the same time, the anthropomorphous apes will no doubt be exterminated. The break between man and his nearest allies will then be wider, for it will intervene between man in a more civilized state, as we may hope, even then the Caucasian and some as low as baboon, instead of as now between the Negro or Australian and the gorilla." According to Darwin, some races were superior. They were more evolved animals. And the lower races, such as Australians or black people or Orientals, will be exterminated by the superior races. And so these concepts were taken by Adolf Hitler and Alfred Rosenberg and applied into fascism. Adolf Hitler, for example, in his book, Mein Kampf means my struggle, my fight. So if you read over this book, you will go over many times the same concepts of Darwinism, struggle for survival, survival of the fittest, and there's a constant conflict between races. And you go over many times these concepts throughout his book. In his book, Adolf Hitler said, "A higher race subjects to itself a lower race, a right which we see in nature and which can be regarded as the sole conceivable right." And he goes on, "The Jews formed a subhuman counter-race, predestined by their biological heritage to evil, just as the Nordic race was designated for nobility. History would culminate in a new millennial empire of unparalleled splendor based on a new racial hierarchy ordained by nature herself." So if you pay attention to the underlying part, he says, new racial hierarchy ordained by nature herself. So he used the theory of evolution as the so-called scientific justification of the Nazism and fascism. Adolf Hitler goes on, "The whole world of nature is a mighty struggle between strength and weakness and eternal victory of the strong over the weak." These are the concepts of Darwinism. There's a mighty struggle between strength and weakness. And the strong ones wins this struggle, and the weak ones get eliminated. There would be nothing but decay in the whole of nature. If this were not so, he who would live must fight. He who does not wish to fight in this world, where permanent struggle is the law of life, has not the right to exist. To think otherwise is to insult nature. Distress, misery, and disease are her rejoinders. Basically, the concepts of Darwinism were taken from Darwinism and applied into Nazism and fascism. And you know what happened? More than 55 million people were killed because of this pervert ideology of fascism and Nazism, which Adolf Hitler used the theory of evolution as the so-called scientific justification of fascism.